Good afternoon, everyone. Today's gonna be a little different from last week. If you remember last week, I was all polished up bright and early on a Sunday morning to show you the beautiful North Belmore build. But today we're back in the trenches. It's cold, it's windy, it's rainy, and it's been a rough day. We've had some setbacks. I've got a bunch of things that I still have to do. It's like 3 o'clock in the afternoon. I'm running out of time. I'm stressing hard, but this is what it is. I'm back in the trenches. Let me show you what we have going on today. I keep it so real with all of you, and one of the things that's a prevalent issue in this business is unforeseen costs. And a large enough unforeseen cost can sink a whole project. Now, I don't have that big of an issue today, but I definitely did have an issue. As I told you guys before, Plainview 2 is actually two lots, and the second lot never had sidewalk for 60 years. So I took a permit to replace the existing sidewalk, do the apron and the sidewalk on the other side, and I left out this whole section, kind of hoping for the best. But before I did the sod and the sprinklers and finished off all my landscaping, I wanted to make sure that they weren't gonna come back and tell me to do this later. And guess what? I did some digging, I talked to the right people, but I wasn't looking to pull a fast one. And I found out that no matter what, because if it's a corner property, you gotta put in the sidewalk and the handicap ramp, it's the builder's responsibility. So guess what? I brought the sidewalk crew back, we're gonna wrap this up, we're gonna put a new handicap ramp in, and this whole project, wrapping this sidewalk all the way around and putting that ramp in, is gonna cost me $5,000 or $6,000, but it is what it is. It's gotta get done. It's an unforeseen cost. We gotta get it back on the back end. While we deal with that setback outside, it's time for intense planning on the inside. Our wood floor is delivered, our inspections are done, so we can run straight through to completion now. And there's so many moving parts. I got the sprinkler guys coming on Tuesday, the trim guy starts Wednesday. Monday and Tuesday, we're installing these floors. It's gonna be nonstop. I've got 4 weeks to deliver this thing complete and ready on the market before the end of April. I'm not being paid by Mapei, but this stuff can save your life. So we go through a lot of different steps to make sure that showers don't leak. The first step is we do a pre-pitch shower pan. Before we actually put the shower liner down, we do a pre-pitch mud, mesh, dry pack, set it all up, get that inspected, then do the shower liner, okay? Put the Duroc on the walls, cement board, whatever you wanna call it. And as one more layer of protection, before we start tiling the shower, we put this product on the walls. Two coats, we tape all the seams, tape all the joints, even cover the shower liner with it, the curb, and this is basically 100% waterproof. Technically, I could probably take a shower in this without any tile and it won't leak. But this little bucket costs $50, and with the labor and everything for the two showers and the one tub, cost me like $500 or $600 to get it done. But now I can sleep at night knowing the shower will never ever leak. On that note, I wanna thank all of you for watching. I still have so much to do, but I wanted to really show you guys what it's like day to day when the project is not done. There's a million things going on and a million moving parts. And if you're interested in this kind of content, then you should definitely follow me on Instagram. @PinnacleRealEstate is my handle. I look forward to seeing you guys here, same time, same place, every Tuesday at 3 o'clock next week. Have a great day, everyone.